Well, are the Cowboys leaving St. Louis late today with a 500 record, or will the Rams finally have a reason to smile after what has been a frustrating and mistake-filled start? Mike March spent the bulk of the week sleeping at Rams Park, working on things, trying to work with the offense, work with the question marks on this team. Deal with the media, deal with the Kurt Warner injury situation. Is there an injury? Troy Aikman telling us before the game that it's not the thumb, it's not the hand, it's the shoulder that's been bothering Warner, and it's gotten progressively worse as this week has worn on. And then there's Dave Campo, a record of 1-2, the embarrassing loss against the Houston Texans. Then they beat Tennessee, which was a surprise, and last week just absolutely dismantled in Philadelphia.
Well, it's been a tough week for both teams for different reasons, and who would have guessed coming into this ball game that the Rams would be winless and the Cowboys would have the better record?
And there is pressure on this Rams team, a different sort of pressure than they've ever really felt in the Kurt Warner, Marshall Faulk, Mike March era. It's one thing when you're going into a Super Bowl and high expectations, and that's a certain kind of pressure. It's an entirely different kind of pressure to be 0-3 and trying to get a win in the win column.
Cowboys won the toss. They receive. Reggie Swinton and Michael Wiley waiting deep. Swinton returned one 100 yards last week at the Vet. Glad you're with us. Swinton gets a crack at it from the two. Good burst to the 29. And that's where Quincy Carter and the Dallas offensive unit will set up shop. The offensive line, they have moved guys all over the place. The only player starting at the same spot, Flozell Adams, Andre Girard was a question mark during the week. He will make the start at center, but the big move is Larry Allen, future Hall of Famer, moving out to the right tackle spot. Emmitt Smith, Robert Thomas in the backfield. The wide receivers, Galloway and Bryant. The tight end is McGee. They start with a throw, a low throw, and the catch is made by Galloway, a gain of 5. The defense for the Rams has been just as poor as the offense when you consider this was a unit that ended up third in the NFL under the direction of Lovie Smith. The linebackers have been very disappointing, and now they're without Tommy Polly, a tear in his groin. He's out 3 weeks. There's the secondary, and they have been picked apart week after week. Second down and 5. Delayed handoff, Emmitt Smith, nowhere to go. Back to the line of scrimmage, that's it. Robert Thomas first there.
Well, a lot of pressure on Quincy Carter coming into this ball game of this week. Jerry Jones came out and speculated as to whether or not Quincy Carter would be the long-term answer at quarterback, and he's had to answer a lot of questions as far as his performance. He's been up and down over the course of this season. They're going to need a good performance out of him today.
Setting up. He's got Bryant wide open. Made a move on Aeneas Williams. And a first down deep inside Rams territory. Boy, down to the 31, a gain of 34.
Excuse me, Joe. Aeneas Williams really bit on this route. Just a little hesitation and go there by Antonio Bryant. Very unlike Aeneas, the Cowboys last week against Philadelphia showed a lot of those underneath quick kind of passes. And I just think that that time Aeneas thought he was going to end up with an interception for a touchdown and gave up a big play.
From the 31 of St. Louis, Emmitt Smith, not much. Adam Archuleta up from the strong safety spot, a gain of only 2.
Troy, I know that sometimes I can overanalyze things, and I don't want to do that all the time. But Robert Thomas, when you're watching him play fullback, there are occasions he just runs right by people. He ran right into the hole and never hit anybody. I know Moose Johnson's a friend of yours, and Emmitt, of course, loves him and was a great lead blocker. But there are times you've got to hit somebody when you go through there, even if it's the wrong guy.
Yeah, and you see Galen Hall right there, the running back coach who was Emmitt Smith's coach when he was with the Florida Gators in college, and he's talking with Robert Thomas about it there.
Second down and 8. crowd is trying to get into it and make some noise. Looking for a reverse. Galloway. The Rams sniff it out. And a loss all the way back to the 36. Leonard Little. Good pressure up from the end. A loss of six.
Well, the Cowboys have struggled with running the football over the first three ball games, but the one thing that they've been able to do is they've been able to run the reverse, and it's the only way they've been able to get outside. You see Leonard Little right here. He's able to hold, contain, and force Emmitt Smith up, force Joey Galloway up inside. But that is one of the only plays they've had all year that have allowed them to get out on the corner. Didn't work there.
Third down and 14, big pressure, big sack, and a big hold for the St. Louis defense. Leonard Little again.
Well, we talked about it so much. Larry Allen moving out to the right tackle position. He's certainly a big, strong, physical guy. The question becomes, can he handle the speed rush of a guy like Leonard Little? And at least the first answer is no.
So two huge defensive plays by the St. Louis Rams to push the Dallas Cowboys back outside field goal range. Mike Anore with Terrence Wilkins waiting deep. High hanging punt and into the end zone. So the Rams dodge a bullet here in the opening minutes in St. Louis in our first look at Kurt Warner and company.
Fox NFL Sunday is brought to you by Southwest Airlines, proud sponsor of the NFL and official airline of Super Bowl 37.
Kurt Warner in the Rams offense. You look at what Kurt Warner has done at home in his NFL career. First 15 games, invincible. The last seven games, a 4-3 record, but 12 touchdowns compared to 16 interceptions. And the Rams have it first and 10 at their own 20. Their 0-3 record and questions all around this offense. They start with it on the ground and Marshall Faulk. Straight up the gut, lost the football. And the Dallas Cowboys have taken over. Dexter Coakley ends up with a football as Marshall Faulk laid it on the turf and Faulk is down.
And you don't know whether it's the neck or not, but boy, he sure is getting up gingerly. And I don't care how tough a guy you are. I don't care how strong a guy you are. If you have a bad neck, and on the first play of the game, you have to go stick it into a pile, it is not a very good feeling. And Roy Williams came up and met him helmet to helmet right there. And Marshall still looks like he's hurting.
Yeah, I don't know that he was completely comfortable coming into this game with his neck. He said all the right things. It was feeling better. But right there, you know, one blow. And coming in, this was going to be a game where they were going to try to give him a heavy dose of the football, let him run and take some of the pass pressure off of Kurt Warner. Offensive line there does a great job and presents a hole for him. And then he just takes the big hit from Roy Williams.
So now the Cowboys get it right back. First down at the Ram 35. Just inside at the 34, and Carter's going to throw. Quick throw, complete to Galloway. He's knocked down just inside the 30. The ball popped out, and the Rams are saying they have it. And they do. Scanina comes away with it as the Rams and Cowboys play. I got it, you take it.
And I know last week, talking with Mike Martz, he was very upset about the fact when the Rams offense turned the ball over that they allowed the Buccaneers offense to go down and get points, and nobody says that they have to be able to score. Right here, great job by the defense of getting the ball back for their offense.
Galloway, the hit by Davis. Scanina with the recovery, and the defense has come up big for the Rams so far. I'm sure fans in Dallas saw the same thing we saw going to break, that the knee of Joey Galloway may have been down before the ball came out, and Dallas has challenged this ruling on the field.
Right there, is that knee on the ground before the ball comes out?
Yeah, and that's the question. The only thing you don't see is, because of the position of his arm and elbow, is in fact the ball moving. Did he have possession of the ball when his knee touched the ground?
And Don Davis, number 58, came in and punched the ball out. But when did the ball actually leave his arm? You can see it before the elbow hit the ground. But was it before the knee hit the ground? That's the question.
There's the punch. There's the ball moving against the body of Galloway. And it, I've changed my mind already.
From that angle, it looked like the ball was, in fact, coming out prior to the knee hitting the ground. On the first angle that we saw, it looked like you could make a case for him having possession when the knee went on the ground.
Well, remember, you have to have conclusive evidence, which really weighs in the Rams' favor here since it was ruled their ball initially. I would have to say, in a completely neutral setting, I thought the knee hit, then the ball was punched out, but it was so close, I don't know if they'll overturn it.
That's the shift I had. I thought definitely the knee was down the first replay we had. Looking at the last two, it looked like the ball started to come out before the knee hit down. We'll get the call from Larry Nemers.
314-992-0633.
There was no, after reviewing the play, there was no indisputable evidence that the ball was not out when the knee hit. Therefore, the ruling on the field stands. Fumble, recovery by St. Louis. Dallas is charged with their first team timeout.
And I think that's the right call. I mean, that's the rule. It's got to be indisputable evidence in order to overturn it. We're up here talking about, did we see it? Did we not see it? Obviously, the official saw the same thing. Nothing was conclusive. Fumble ball.
I agree.
Well, now the Rams have it. They've run only one play on offense. They had a huge hole up the middle. Marshall Faulk had the first down, then got dinged, fumbled, and yet he's back out there at the moment, set up behind Hetherington, the fullback. Conwell and Manu Malayuna, the two tight ends, are in there, and they go right back to Faulk. Darren Woodson made the stop after a gain of 8. And we go back to Los Angeles and check in with James Brown.
Hey, Joe, Buffalo's opening drive of 75 yards capped with this 2-yard pass from Drew Bledsoe to Pierce Price. Buffalo up 7-0. Take a look at Detroit. Already up 3-0. Aaron Brooks hit. Fumble recovered by James Hall. He takes it 21 yards to pay dirt. Believe it or not, Detroit on top 10-0. Back to Joe Buck.
All right, James Brown. Saying we got them right where we want them. After they came back down 20-0 last week against Chicago. Three plays. They've run it three times with Marshall Faulk. He just got one, and he's about a yard shy of a first down. The offensive line, look at the tackles. John St. Clair, he struggled all year. He's still at right tackle, and Grant Williams is taking the place of the injured Orlando Pace. The running backs, Faulk and Hetherington, they miss James Hodgins. Then Holton Bruce, and the tight end is Ernie Conwell. Third and one. And a toss to Faulk. Penalty flag on the play as Faulk was brought down shy of the first down. Thrown in the area of a hold, and we'll check the marker. It is a hold, but Faulk's indicating it's against Dallas.
Holding, defense, number 97. That's a 5-yard penalty, automatic first down.
The old defensive holding from the defensive tackle.
Yeah, that's Leroy Glover, and you see him there, 97, right here. They got him for hold. Right there is when he grabs the lineman and pulls him down. That was Adam Timmerman that he pulled down on the ground, and they caught him on it. And I tell you, Leroy Glover has been a tremendous addition for this football team. He came from New Orleans Saints last year. He's a guy who works hard in practice. He's been, after one season, really three games, one of the big leaders for this team in the locker room, and really a great player, and he's had a lot to do with Greg Ellis in the year that he's had rushing the passer already.
And let's talk about why he would do that so he could open it up for the linebackers to fill in behind.
We've had a lot of veterans step up, the Cowboys have this past week, and try to light a fire under this Cowboys team. Play action pass. Wide open is Marshall Faulk. A breakdown defensively and a first down at the Dallas 40. They are going to work on the linebackers of the Dallas Cowboys today.
Well, this is really what you've got to do. The Cowboys have been playing this cover two defense with the two deep safeties. You watch these linebackers underneath and how deep that they get. Right here is where this group of linebackers is. And when you get that kind of depth with that intermediate defense, then you're going to open up some things underneath to Marshall Faulk like that. Great patience by Kurt Warner
from the Dallas 40. Warner under pressure, throws, and it's picked off by Ellis. All kinds of pressure from Roy Williams. There's Warner looking at the back of his hand as he has just thrown his eighth interception.
Well, we talked about a lot of different things. Here comes Roy Williams right off the bottom of your screen on the blitz. Kurt Warner obviously sees him and rushes this throw on the screen. There have been a lot of interceptions so far this year that have not been the fault of Kurt Warner. This one clearly is. He got rushed, he got hurried, and he made a bad play because you had Ellis coming up right in position to make the interception.
And then probably most importantly, they're working on Kurt Warner right now. He came off immediately grabbing his hand, hollering for a trainer, and they're looking at it now.
Second turnover for St. Louis, and the Cowboys run it with their fullback, Robert Thomas. He got three.
Yo, here's a look at that last play that he throws, and it looks like right there when it goes into the turf, somehow, if it's his wrist or his hand, something, but he immediately came off the field and summoned for some help by the trainer.
Jamie Martin is starting to loosen up as they look at the right hand of Kurt Warner. Second down and seven for Dallas. We've had some action, but no points. Carter, wide open. That's his fullback Thomas, and he's got a first down at the Ram 41. Gain of 15.
And the Cowboys better come up with an answer for Leonard Little on the backside. So far, they've had tight ends trying to help on him. They've had big Larry Allen out there trying to block him, and he is getting close. He almost got to Quincy Carter again on that one. He could well have a big day today.
Little checks out on first and 10. Carter steps up and throws, and it's dropped by the rookie Bryant.
Well, you see Kurt Warner going in to get it checked out, his hand. And that is not a good sign. I know he's had problems with that hand and the finger and the thumb, and we said coming into this game that everything was fine with that, but clearly not feeling good now. You can see that index or the pinky finger right there. Dislocation, it appears, of the index or pinky finger.
Second down and 10. That's Emmett Smith. He gets a couple. That's all. Third and long coming up. Mike March telling us yesterday, we have got to protect Kurt Warner, which is a change in philosophy. And then he went on to say, if we lose number 13, we're in big trouble. And it looks like for the moment, they've lost number 13.
Well, I think, you know, in the past, he's always kind of had a bravado attitude about, hey, we do what we do. We're not worried about Kurt getting hit. I think now, after the last 2 weeks, the pounding that he's taken, he is now concerned about the hits that he's had.
Third down and 9 for Dallas. Carter over the middle. The catch is made. Bryant was tapped short of the first down. And we go down to the sideline and Pam Oliver. Pam?
All right, Joe. Kurt Warner taken into the locker room. As you saw, he's got a dislocated pinky finger on his throwing hand. He's gone in now for some x-rays to determine the extent of the injury. And obviously a lot of offensive players down here very concerned. Back to you.
And I know every quarterback holds the ball differently. For me, the way that I held the football, which is a little unorthodox, the pinky would be a real problem. You know, it may not be a problem for Kurt Warner as far as throwing the football.
For the first time this season, the Cowboys are going for it on fourth down. Penalty flag on the play, incomplete pass, and we'll check the marker.
The defense had 12 men on the field to snap. The 5-yard penalty will result in a first down.
Lovie Smith dumbfounded that his defense would have 12 guys on the field. They did stop Dallas, but why not? They had an extra guy.
You talk about a huge play in the ball game right there. Fourth down, the pass incomplete. You're going to stop them. Their defense did such a great job last week against Tampa Bay, despite all the futility on the offensive side of keeping this team in it. And now basically a gift for the Dallas Cowboys.
On first down, a toss to Emmitt Smith. A lot of room to run. Knocked down with a Dallas first down.
Well, let's see if we can count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. That's exactly how many they have. Good job by the officials.
Travis Fisher, a rookie out of Central Florida, was the one that came out answering to Lovie Smith. Larry Allen out of the lineup, bothered by his left ankle, and Javier Collins is in it, wide open. Darnay Scott, the St. Louisan, for a touchdown.
Well, Quincy's going to roll out here to the right. It's off of play action, which is what they like to do. Sprint out here to the right. Get all the defense moving in that direction. You see Darnay Scott, he fakes and rolls. That's part of the play. Get everybody off of him and leaves them wide open for the touchdown.
And I'll bet you the Cincinnati Bengals, when Bruce Kozel was there, scored 10 touchdowns off that exact play.
With 5:19 remaining in the first quarter, it's a 7-0 Dallas lead. The Rams have turned it over twice and may have lost Kurt Warner. The Cowboys jump on top as they try to even their record today at 2-2. All eyes are on Kurt Warner. He's back out on the field with his hands on his hips, and we'll see if he comes back into this game. The scoring drive for Dallas, 7 plays covering 59 yards, and the one that got him into the end zone, Darnay Scott. 17-yard reception from number 17, Quincy Carter. This is Wilkins. He is smacked at the 25. The Rams offense back onto the field. Jamie Martin getting ready to play. 7-0 Dallas.
Fox NFL Sunday is brought to you by Subway. Fresh made sandwiches on fresh baked bread. Subway, eat fresh. By Chevy Trucks, the most dependable, longest lasting trucks on the road. By Universal Pictures, before the silence of the lambs, there was Red Dragon. Friday. And by Miller Lite, life is best told in a place called Miller Time.
Beautiful day outside, as inside, it's anything but beautiful for the hometown St. Louis Rams. Down 7-0, and they've lost Kurt Warner for at least the next short while, as Marshall Faulk falls forward, gets 4 yards, and we go down to the sideline and Pam Oliver.
All right, Joe, the news on Kurt Warner, a little worse than expected. That right pinky finger is broken. Remember, he broke that same pinky finger a couple of years ago against Kansas City. He missed about 6 weeks the last time. Back to you.
Thank you, Pam. There it is right there. Pinky finger that he broke. That was in the 2000 season at Kansas City. Second down, and Martin throws. Pass is complete. That's Marshall Faulk. Jamie Martin went down early in the preseason with a separated throwing shoulder. Look at his 8-year career. This is actually his second go-around with the Rams.
Yeah, and Jamie Martin last year is when he joined the team, and he joined them late in the offseason. And so he didn't get to go through the offseason program. He didn't go through the training camp last year. This was his first offseason to spend with the Rams. And then he was going to get his opportunity in training camp to really get acclimated with his offense. But then he separated his shoulder. So he's a guy who really has not played that much within this offense.
Third down and 3. Wide open. First down, Torrey Holt.
But Jamie Martin is also a guy that you know the Rams believe in. They signed him to a long-term deal. They feel like he is the perfect guy to be the backup quarterback here. Back in 95 with the Amsterdam Admirals, played 9 games there, 11 touchdowns, 6 interceptions, and helped them win the World Bowl title. So here's a guy that has some experience in big games.
First down for St. Louis. The ball at their own 39. Martin too high for Conwell. Kevin Hardy with some late pressure on Jamie Martin.
Well, and right now we said coming into this game that Marshall Faulk was going to be a big part of this game plan because of the problems within the offensive line. Now he even becomes a much bigger part of this offensive game plan because of the inexperience of Jamie Martin.
You know, but what's been interesting is when Kurt Warner was in the game, they were handing the ball off to Marshall Faulk. Now that you've got Jamie Martin in the game, they're dropping back and throwing the ball. There were some big holes right up front.
Just got the play away and a draw play to Marshall Faulk. He gets out to the 42, had to fight for his 3 yards. If you look at time spent trailing, this is an interesting graphic. The Rams in 4 games this season have already spent more minutes trailing than they have in the previous 2 seasons.
And I think that's part of why we see what it is that we're seeing here today as far as them going from a running game plan early, now with Jamie Martin throwing the football. When they get behind, they become impatient. They want to go back down the field and get those touchdowns and get back in these ball games.
Can they do that with Jamie Martin at quarterback? He's going to run. Big hit by Williams, and Martin is short of a first down.
Boy, Roy Williams has been a factor in this ball game already. So far, we've already seen him on the blitz, force the interception by Kurt Warner. And now when it looks like Jamie Martin's going to scramble out for the first down, Roy Williams just came ripping up out of that. And he wants a shot at this quarterback. He said, I want to see what your number 3 quarterback looks like.
Yeah, when you go head first like that as a quarterback, it opens yourself up to get blown up. If you slide, the defense then is not able to take a shot like that.
And Roy Williams, a guy who is much more comfortable playing around the line of scrimmage and blitzing and playing the run than he is back playing the pass.
Again, they just get the snap away and an ugly kick from Berger, but it takes a good bounce. And the Cowboys will start with it at their own 6. Ugly but useful. Dallas has it and a 7-0 lead. Well, what's coming up in October? We've been telling you it's a big month. We got baseball, we got football next week. Good matchups, including these Rams out in San Francisco. That's the late game after the Giants and Cowboys. And the Eagles and Jaguars, as well as that Rams game. It all starts with Fox NFL Sunday, noon Eastern, 9 a.m. Pacific. Delayed handoff, Emmitt Smith. Up the middle, open field, near sideline, and tripped up at the 35 by Dre Bly. 30-yard run by Emmitt Smith.
Well, that's the best run Emmitt has had this season. They do a nice job on that right side of just collapsing it down. You see right here, collapsing the tack, the defensive end down inside. It gives a lane for Emmitt Smith to run up inside, and he doesn't have quite the same burst that he had a few years ago, but you give him a hole like that, he's going to pick up some pretty good yards. They did it behind the side without Larry Allen as well.
Javier Collins is in at right tackle, and he just moved too soon. And I would, too, if I had to try to slow down Leonard Little.
Boy, if you take a step back right here.
False start offense, number 70. 5-yard penalty, still first down.
You're looking at this Rams team. They come in here at 0-3. Marshall Faulk has the bad neck. Orlando Pace, who may well be the best offensive lineman, at least on this football team. And now you've got Kurt Warner out. So if you're Mike Martz, Troy, I think you really have to take a bit of a different approach to this ball game now. They've seen they've had success early trying to run the football, but this isn't going to be one of those 30-point days today. It's going to be like a 17-14 kind of a game.
Michael Wiley in the backfield. Good play by the Rams linebackers as Duncan makes a play. And we go down to the sideline. And Pam Oliver.
All right, Joe, right tackle Larry Allen, hobbled by a sprained ankle, has re-aggravated the injury. The trainers have retaped that ankle. So far, though, Larry Allen remains sidelined. Back to you.
A lot of tape. You got any tape, Cris?
There you go.
You got any tape, Troy?
I taped my ankles before I got up here.
That's the end of the first quarter. The score, Dallas 7, St. Louis nothing. I think you might want to stick around and see what happens the rest of this day. The NFL on Fox will continue after these messages. Start of the second quarter after a wild first period here in St. Louis. Only 7-0 on the scoreboard, but a lot has happened. On second down, a dump off pass to Emmitt Smith. He gets up to the 39, third down coming up for Dallas. Now, the former quarterback for the Dallas Cowboys would be Troy Aikman. And Troy, if you dislocated your pinky finger, how would you throw the football?
Well, I wouldn't be able to. I mean, the dislocation, you can do it with some guys, but the way I grip the ball, I would never have been able to do it. But you're not talking about a dislocation. You're talking about a broken finger, and that's an entirely different situation.
You want to know how I would throw it?
Yeah.
The same way.
Poorly?
Poorly.
End over end?
Yes.
It's third and 7. That's Thomas out of the backfield. Good tackle in the open field. That's the rookie Travis Fisher. Time for Dallas to punt. We go back to Los Angeles and check in with JB.
Chicago makes you pay for mistakes. Take a look at Travis Henry. The fumble right here is picked up by linebacker Roosevelt Colvin. He laterals to Mike Brown, 60 yards to pay dirt, 7-7. 34 points over turnovers this season for Chicago. Back to Joe Buck.
All right, James Brown, Micah Knorr, his second punt of the day. Terrence Wilkins waiting deep. Ugly punt. And the catch under duress. And the tackle is made. 1 yard return as Tony Dixon came up with the stop, and there is a penalty flag on the field.
I think the Cowboys came to play today. They were embarrassed early by the Eagles last week.
Holding during the kick. On the return team, number 54. That penalty will be enforced from the end of the kick, 10 yards, first down, St. Louis.
Cole Ai, guilty of the hold. Jamie Martin at the controls of this high-powered offense, at least high-powered coming into this year. Second try at it for the Rams offense under the direction of Jamie Martin. After the penalty on the punt return, the Rams start with it at their own 14. Torrey Holt, first down. Out past the 34-yard line as Roy Williams made the stop.
Well, certainly nobody's going to confuse Jamie Martin for Kurt Warner, but if you look at this throw and the way he's able to fit this thing in, Torrey Holt comes up and he gets up inside. There's not much of a window there. He's having to throw it over Kevin Hardy, the linebacker, who had dropped in there pretty good, and Jamie Martin delivers a strike.
I'm going to tell you what, though. You're not going to make a living all day making that throw. That's a pretty tough shot in there.
Up the middle, Conwell. First down at the Dallas 40. Troy, if there's ever going to be a day, if you want to be Jamie Martin and succeed, if he gets protection against this Cowboys secondary, this could be a good way for him to get in
there. Well, there's no question. He comes right back after that last throw. Now he's got Ernie Conwell working down and fits in another tight ball. It's obvious that this kid is not lacking confidence in throwing the football in some pretty tight spaces.
Like I said, I think he can make a living all day with those kinds of throws.
Good point. It's first down, and it's a handoff to Falk. gets brought down from behind by Leroy Glover, a gain of two. Let's go back to the Kurt Warner injury. Roy Williams with the hit. Warner gets up, looks at his pinky on his right hand, which is broken. Dislocated and broken. They put a splint on it, but now Warner's got a headset on while his offense is out on the field.
Yeah, Mike March told us. He said, the one guy I cannot lose is number 13, Kurt Warner. He's lost them for this game. Jamie Martin has filled in nicely up to this point.
Second down, blitz coming. Rams pick it up enough, and wide open is Holt for a first down. Actually, Bruce. And after he gets wrestled to the ground by Ross, who had a hold of Bruce's helmet, Bruce gets up a little hot. Let's go out to Los Angeles and James Brown with a game break.
Hey, Joe, and on this Carolina scoring drive against Green Bay, Rodney Pete hooking up with Steve Smith. Take a look at Steve Smith. Poor tackling by Green Bay as well. Five missed tackles on this scoring drive. Penalty tacked on half the distance. Lamar Smith's three-yard run makes it 7-3 Carolina. Back to Joe Buck.
Here's an end around, and now a pass from Cole to Holt. Incomplete. He came down with it, but out of bounds.
Boy, and he was covered too. I thought Pro would tuck that one and try to get what he could out of it. Cowboys do a nice job of spotting that one out.
Let me tell you something. When you give a wide receiver the ball and give him the option of throwing it, he ain't running it. He's going to take a shot. They almost got it in there.
Sure did. You got Lynn Scott back there, 21. Perfect position. He has an opportunity for the interception. Great concentration by Torrey Holt. Unable to get his feet in bounds, however.
Got the right foot down. Couldn't get the left down. Second and 10. Rams pick up another blitz. This one's picked off. Intercepted by Woodson. 22nd career interception, and the Rams have turned it over for the third time today. Jamie Martin takes over for Kurt Warner. Warner's thrown a pick today, and now so has Martin, as Woodson and the Cowboys come away with it. A 7-0 Dallas lead. They have the ball, and the Rams ask for a lot out of their defense today. Woodson with the interception, and the crowd climbs in. Empty backfield and a quick throw to Whalen, the tight end.
We'll go back and take a look at the interception. Here's Darren Woodson right here. He's going to work up in here and act as though he's going to the flat to cover the flat defender. You see him there, he starts sinking back underneath. Jamie Martin never sees him, and that's why you have the interception.
Plus, you had Jamie Martin just staring down his receiver, something Kurt Warner was accused of last week. That allowed Woodson to drop back.
Emmitt Smith. Lost yardage, and it's third down coming up for Dallas.
Well, and this Cowboy team offensively has had problems in mostly in third and one situations. Right there, you were looking at a second and one situation. Emmitt Smith has failed to get a first down on the last five second and one or third and one situations.
And we saw him last week against Philadelphia actually just go to a naked bootleg so they wouldn't have to try and jam it up there.
Third and one. Now a toss to Smith. Does he have enough burst? They mark him out of bounds with a first down. First down, Dallas. And he just got there.
You know, in last week's ball game against Tampa Bay, Dre Bly did not tackle very well. You see him right here. He's in position to tackle Emmitt Smith, keep him from getting the first down. He comes in with a shoulder, never gets his arms wrapped around him, and that seems to be a thing that more and more defensive backs are trying to do to bring down ball carriers, is just throw a shoulder in it, and you can't bring down a good back doing it like that.
First down for Dallas. Carter has it batted down. Ryan Pickett in the middle.
We did so much talking about the protection issues for these two teams coming into the ball game, But this time by the Dallas Cowboys, just absolutely picture-perfect protection. Quincy Carter able to step up, just gets the ball knocked down. You got to find those throwing lanes to throw the ball through.
Yeah, and I know they've been a much maligned group, that offensive line, and struggled in the opener against Houston. Their second ball game against Tennessee actually did a nice job, giving Quincy ample time to throw the football.
Second down and 10. This is Hambrick. Lowers his shoulder and fights forward for another Dallas first down. While the Cowboys get a fresh set of downs, we'll remind you that October's magical matchups begin on Tuesday as the Angels travel to the Bronx to take on the Yankees, or Jim Edmonds and the Cardinals take on the Diamondbacks, the world champion Diamondbacks. The road to the World Series begins Tuesday at 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific on Fox.
You get to do a little baseball, right, Joe?
I will be back. No penalty flag as Carter is going to run and slide. It's hard to believe that Quincy Carter came into this game with only 7 rushes for 8 yards, and they want him to do a little more moving around.
And I wonder if Quincy could actually hear Jerry Jones's voice in his head there. He came out, he had his eyes looking down the field. You remember what Jerry Jones said earlier this week? We want you to get out. We want you to run more. Be like Donovan McNabb. Get out there. And then he sat there and he said, oh, okay. And then he just sort of ran and slid in.
You know, and Quincy's played about like what you would expect a second-year player to play. He has his good games, he has his good moments, and then he has his bad moments.
Second down and 8. Hambrick. You can tell with Hambrick touching the ball twice that he has much more burst than Emmitt Smith.
Well, he did last year anyway. You know, last year he got an opportunity to carry the football. He led the league in yards per attempt. He didn't get a lot of opportunities to carry the ball because he backs up Emmitt Smith. But this year when he's had his chances, he really hasn't done much with them. These last 2 carries that he's had is the best that I've seen him run the ball this year. And he's really auditioning for next year. There's a lot of speculation as to whether Emmitt's going to be back and who's going to be the guy to replace him.
3rd and 3. The throw, the completion, the first down to Whalen.
I don't know, Troy. Doesn't look like he's auditioning right now. He's been in the game for 3 straight plays. And I played for Bruce Coslett in Cincinnati. And of course, Emmitt Smith coming back into ball game right now. But we were talking about it earlier. If Troy Hambrick gets hot, Bruce Coslett will take him out of the ballgame. Now, I'm telling you, he's a guy, he'll irritate you, he'll make you mad, he'll drive you nuts. But if you get a hot hand, he's going to leave you in the football game.
A drive that started at their own 4 is out to the 38-yard line. And Emmitt Smith wrestled down. And the best open field tackler in this game so far for the Rams is the rookie Travis Fisher.
Yeah, Travis Fisher and another corner who obviously tackles well for them is Aeneas Williams. But Travis Fisher, the rookie, getting his opportunity to play today. And when you're going to play cover 2, which is a predominant coverage for this Rams defense, you've got to be able to have corners that are willing to come up and make tackles. We saw earlier where Dre Bly was unable to do that. On that play there, Travis Fisher did.
2nd down and 10. Blitz coming. Quick throw. Galloway. Both Fisher and Duncan combined for the stop.
One of the things we saw watching the film last week against the Philadelphia Eagles, and they're a team that loves the blitz, really makes their living with the blitz, is that Quincy Carter, I thought, really handled the blitz beautifully last week against Philadelphia, having a pretty good day here today as well. He doesn't get shook up. He keeps himself under control and actually forced the Eagles to not blitz as much as they usually do.
Yeah, I think Bruce Coslett helps him out with some of the things that he calls in that area.
3rd down and 6. Grant Wistrom, the ball comes out. It goes out of bounds, and it's time for Dallas to punt, and there's the effort and hustle by Grant Wistrom. I know you are impressed with the engine that's inside.
Well, I really am. Grant Wistrom is going to be right down here, and when he comes off the ball, he does not waste any steps. I mean, he is 100 miles an hour. The thing interesting there was he wasn't even trying to rush the passer. He was just running straight down the line of scrimmage. I don't know if there was something that the Cowboys offense showed that tipped him to the fact that it was going to be a rollout by Quincy Carter.
5 minutes remaining in this first half. And penalty flags in whistles before the snap. It's a delay of game.
There'll be no foul on the play. The delay was caused by the fumble forward when we brought the ball back, so there'll be no penalty on the play. Still fourth down.
So they reset the play clock to 25, and they've put a new bandage and wrap and some ice on the right hand of Kurt Warner.
Well, I know for me, I had a broken index finger. I had a broken index finger as a rookie, and they had to go in and surgically repair it. I missed six ball games because of it. I couldn't throw the football. You know, when you're talking about the pinky, it's a little different for some guys. They don't use as much pressure with it. He may, in fact, be able to come back and play much sooner. I don't know. But it'll be interesting to find out whether or not this is a break that's going to require surgery.
There's an injury in the year 2000 that he suffered across the state in Kansas City. Cost him five games. The punt from Norr. Fair catch called for. The punt was muffed. Penalty flag on the play, and it looks like Wilkins recovered it anyway. But there is another marker on that play. Wilkins did a good job just to get back on top of that ball.
And the official with his hat off, which means that probably somebody on the Dallas Cowboys ran out of bounds and came back in and maybe was the first to touch the football.
We have a personal foul on the receiving team number 27, who went out of bounds and blocked a defender. That penalty will be enforced from the end of the kick, half the distance to the goal.
Once the gunner goes out of bounds, you have to allow him to get back in the field of play before you start to block him again. Obviously on that one, the contact well outside the boundary line.
Here's Wilkins, able to get back on top of it, and a good thing for the Rams that he did. They had it down seven.
Fox NFL Sunday is brought to you by GM, the car company in overdrive.
Interesting day in St. Louis. Rams fans wondering what's next. Jamie Martin and this Rams offense setting up. Ball at their own 13. Delay and handoff to Falk. And a penalty flag in the backfield as Ellis climbed on top of Jamie Martin, rather Ekubon, instead of Greg Ellis, and Ekubon's pleading his case.
I think Ekubon's saying he was blocked into the quarterback, so it shouldn't be a foul.
And they're discussing that very point.
Well, and here's Ekubon here, and the hit that they're referring to, and you know he certainly wasn't trying to do anything vicious. He got blocked and tried to hold up and just hit him down low.
Well, there's, I don't know, Troy. I don't know if he could have kept from going down low, and of course that's one of the rules that you're not allowed to hit the quarterback below the knees either.
Number 96 defense into the back of the legs of the quarterback. That's a 15-yard penalty. First down.
I think that's an easy call, and he was blocked on the play, but certainly not blocked into the quarterback.
Here's a reaction by Dave Campo after the penalty. Get him out of there.
I totally agree. I think that's all on him.
Well, and Ebenezer Ekubon, he has had some problems over the course of his career. One, he's had a hard time staying healthy, but then also he was in a real dogfight with Pepe Zellner this year, and a lot of people felt that Pepe Zellner should be the starting end for them, and he's the one who has just replaced Ebenezer. And here's Pepe Zellner right here.
First down for the Rams. The throw is behind the intended receiver. Dexter Copley with the coverage, and Isaac Bruce had it thrown behind him by Jamie Martin.
You know, I think what they're trying to do is they want to get Jamie Martin into this game, allow him to complete some passes. They know that at some point in the third, fourth quarter, he's going to have to show up. He's going to have to be able to make some plays. But I think right now they need to continue to give a heavy dose of Marshall Faulk. When Marshall has ran the ball, he's had success, and that takes the pressure off of Jamie.
Second down and 10 now. Play clock down to 2. Conwell dropped it. Had a little room to run, but dropped it. Third and 10 now.
One of the basic schemes for the St. Louis Rams trying to help John St. Clair on that right side is that they're going to give some help over here to this tackle and then release out late, this time with Ernie Conwell. The play is there, beautifully set up. You just have to catch a football. I mean, you can't get any more open than that.
Yeah, and the Rams have always dropped some passes, but I've never seen them drop this many passes at this point in the season. Every week that we've watched them, they've had 2 or 3 critical drops that would have helped them.
Now a 3rd and 10, high snap. Martin in trouble, and now Faulk drops it. Martin's going to need all the help he can get, and he just had back-to-back drops by Conwell and Faulk.
Yeah, and when you're playing with a young guy, you've got Jamie Martin in the ball game, a guy who has not played much. He's very inexperienced quarterback position in these ball games, and the guys around him have got to be able to rally. Jamie Martin does a nice job of avoiding the rush, getting the ball out, and these other players, the Marshall Faulks, the Isaac Holtz, or the Isaac Bruces, the Torrey Holtz, those guys, Ernie Conwell, they've got to be able to make plays around him.
But Troy, the pressure is starting to get there now. We saw Leroy Glover that time. We've seen this defensive line getting home now.
Line drive punt by Mitch Berger. Swinton from the 5. Swinton is drilled out of bounds.
You ain't going out of bounds. He's walk out of bounds. He's
frustration through week 4 here in St. Louis. And it continues now with Martin in the lineup. Marshall Faulk frustrated. 7-0 Dallas. Cowboys with the ball and the lead, 7-0. Under 4 to play here in the first half. Their offensive leaders, Quincy Carter's off to a good start. Emmitt Smith with one big 30-yard run, which pads his stats. And Antonio Bryant has 2 catches. Marshall Faulk seething over on the sidelines as the Cowboys start with it from their own 25. And Emmitt Smith just trying to find some room to run. Got 1 yard. Let's go down to Pam Oliver.
Okay, Joe, a little more information on Kurt Warner's injury. That fracture on his right pinky finger is not exactly the same break as the last time. If and when Kurt Warner has surgery will be determined after a re-examination on Monday. Back to you.
All right, Pam, thanks.
And Troy, I'm sorry.
Go ahead.
I think that you saw with Emmitt Smith that time, he really has no faith whatsoever in this blocking scheme. I mean, that was a cut that shouldn't have been made. The play was out here to the outside.
Second down and 9. That's batted and incomplete. Bryant was open, and then it was nearly picked off by Don Davis.
Well, there's a play. Quincy Carter had a guy open, and they just able to get a hand on it. And then you got Don Davis, and those are the plays. Those are, you know, we see it on the offensive side of the ball where they're not catching the football, and then you see it on the defensive side of the ball where they're not getting the, when they have opportunities for turnovers, they're not capitalizing on them.
See that score, 20-0, Detroit leading at home over New Orleans. Aeneas Williams out with an ankle, may return. Third down and 9, big pressure. Little could not corral Carter, and the throw is completed, but short of a first down. Kenyon Rambo with a catch.
Well, that was a little closer to Donovan McNabb right there, and as we talked about the entire game, Leonard Little, the Cowboys just have no answer for him. Javier Collins over there playing now where Larry Allen was, and he is just a living nightmare right now for this Cowboys offense. They're going to have to start to help on him.
The Rams have to use a timeout. Dallas lost one when a challenge didn't work their way, and now the Rams will have 2 timeouts left as they intend to get the ball back here. Let's go to James Brown in Los Angeles with a game break.
Hey, Joe, here's a visual embellishment of what Detroit is doing. Joey Harrington looked excellent on his drive. 2 of 2 for 78 yards, including this 38-yard to Billy Schrader. 20-0, the Lions over New Orleans. Drew Bledsoe's second touchdown toss of the day. That one to Eric Moe. Buffalo on top by 10 over Chicago. Joe, Troy, and Chris.
Thank you, James.
And how long do you think it'll be before a player of Drew Bledsoe's caliber is available to the other teams in the NFL? I even called his agent, tried to get him to Cincinnati. I said, oh, please come. We'll build a statue, anything you need.
You wear a lot of hats, don't you?
I do. I've got a lot of jobs to do.
Mike Anor with another punt. And on the run, somehow, Terrence Wilkins pulls it in cleanly. It has been a soap opera around here of sorts for the Rams this season. A little updated version of As the World Turns. A 4th-and-2 in Denver didn't work. An ugly day against the New York Giants. And then what's new? The Tampa Bay defense just swarming the Rams offense. And then today, the injury to Kurt Warner, the broken pinky on the right hand after the hit by Roy Williams. From their own 37. Setting up a screen for Falk. Makes a move, crosses the 40, picked up 5.
And with all that's happened, when you talk about them coming into this game 0-3, that last shot of Kurt Warner going down is the worst thing possibly that could happen to this football team, and you just hope that he's not going to be out for an extended length of time.
Second down and 5. Over the middle, Falk. First down into Dallas territory.
I like seeing the Rams going into this two-minute offense. When you're having trouble pass protecting, it really slows down those big defensive linemen when they have to play in a hurry up. They get tired.
Well, the two-minute warning hit, and that is a ridiculous mistake if indeed they call the pass incomplete.
Yeah, I don't think they counted the play. I think the two-minute warning got there first.
That's where we are, 7-0 Cowboys. Jamie Martin's an 8-year player. He just made a mistake. The officials got together and ruled it an incomplete pass, the two-minute warning as well. So it's 2nd down and 10.
The ball was snapped with 2 minutes and 1 second to go. Therefore, the pass was incomplete and the down counts at 2nd down.
2 minutes and about half a second to go, but I do think the officials got it right. And a big mistake that time by Jamie Martin.
And as Martin backpedaled, the clock went down to 1:59 when he spiked it. 2nd down and 10. Another dump off to Falk. 1st down, St. Louis inside the 35 to the 32. The Rams will have 1 timeout remaining. And a 1st down, down 7.
Here's that last play. You can see the screen. And what a great job Adam Timmerman and Andy McCollum do of getting out in front of Marshall Faulk. You see them coming to the screen. 67. Andy McCollum gets the first one. Adam Timmerman gets the second one and allows Marshall to get up inside of all that and pick up a big gain. That's one of the things that they've done today that they've been successful at.
It's a hardware store drive, one screen after another. Blitz coming. Yo Murphy. All he can get to is the 29, but a good job by Jamie Martin to get rid of it.
Roy Williams has already knocked out Kurt Warner, and now he's trying to get Jamie Martin. He's tearing these guys up.
Martin's also tearing up some Rams timeouts. They're out as they use their last. Coming up on the Visa Halftime Report, JB, Terry, Howie, and Jimmy will have scores and highlights from around the league, and the Fox Sports ticker will keep you updated with up to the second stats. Do they have the two-minute drill over in NFL Europe? Because Jamie Martin's having a tough time.
Well, unfortunately, the backup quarterback rarely gets to work in the two-minute situations. Right there, I don't really understand why he called timeout. One of the things you want to do as an offense is get the defense on their heels, and they had them there. They called timeout and allowed them to set up.
Blitz coming again from Dallas. Wide open
Aikman is Holt.
And he has a first down at the Dallas 16.
I know they want to come after Jamie Martin, but we saw it last week against the Philadelphia Eagles. Mario Edwards and Derek Ross and Dwayne Hawthorne, they're just not going to hold up for very long in man coverage. If they couldn't cover the Eagles receivers in one-on-one situations, they're certainly not going to be able to cover the Rams.
Halloween time, 1999, the last time the Rams were shut out in the first half. We're trying to avoid that. And penalty flags before the snap.
And the Cowboys were back into their cover two zone defense there.
Prior to the ball being snapped, offense false start, number 81. 5-yard penalty, still first down.
Torrey Holt trying to get a jump. Yeah, there's really absolutely no excuse for a wide receiver to ever be offside. You're not supposed to be listening to the quarterback. You're supposed to be looking down the line of scrimmage, watching the ball, and just inexcusable for a wide receiver to be offsides, particularly when you're down here in the red zone.
That never happened to the Cowboys in the early to mid 90s.
You didn't watch many of our games.
First down and 15.
To the end zone. Bruce, what a throw and catch. You watch Jamie Martin in sync here, and the Isaac Holt on the other side. He gets a great release inside, comes back out. Derek Ross. That is a perfect throw by Jamie Martin. Unbelievable.
We had trouble managing timeouts in the 2-minute warning, but no trouble taking the Rams down the field. And with a minute 25 remaining in this first half, it's a tie game. We will rally around Jamie Martin, and we will continue to play football. Martin celebrating, Warner smiling. Oh, all is well in St. Louis. We're tied.
First of the year for Isaac Bruce. 7 play drive covering 69 yards, a minute 19 off the clock. And some impressive throws, especially that last one over the shoulder of Isaac Bruce. And now the Dallas Cowboys will get it back. It was so important for the Rams defense to hold Dallas out of the end zone again to allow Jamie Martin to get into some sort of rhythm and not be forced to try and win the game in the first half right off the bench. And they've been able to do that. It's 7-7 with a minute 25 left. This is Swinton. From inside the end zone, he's going to take a knee.
Well, you look here at this offensive line and the job that they're able to do. We talked about Grant Williams at left tackle, St. Clair at right tackle. They do a nice job on the edges and then up front, giving Jamie Martin a pocket to step up into.
And Joe, I want to go back to a point that you made. You can't understate the importance of Jamie Martin now being able to go into the locker room, having thrown a touchdown pass, a little momentum for these Rams, because they were really lifeless until that drive.
Now Dallas with a chance. They have 2 timeouts remaining. Short throw and completion to Wiley, who instead of running out of bounds is tackled by Travis Fisher yet again.
Yeah, and the good thing that the Cowboys have right here is that the Rams are out of timeouts, so they don't have to worry about the Rams getting the ball back if they're unable to get a first down here.
Setting up a screen for Hamburg. The Rams have come alive. The rookie, Robert Thomas, with a hit in the backfield.
And the one thing you don't want to do, though, is you don't want to give this Rams offense another shot here. Obviously, they're going to go back to the huddle now, try and run this clock out so they don't have to punt the football and give the Rams one more shot.
Right, they'll run it here, and then the half will be over.
Big Larry Allen being walked into the dressing room early, re-injured that ankle. didn't play last week. They moved him to right tackle this week and was out of this one early. That's Wiley. Rams trying to dig the ball out of there. That's going to be it for the first half.
Yeah, and Wiley's not very smart there, trying to run for extra yardage. He wasn't going to get the first down, and he needed to just hit the ground and run the clock out.
The crowd's back in it. The Rams trying to get back in it. Dallas scored early, and it's 7-7 at the end of the first half. Stay tuned for the Visa Halftime Show with JB, Jerry, Howie, and Jimmy. Right after these messages and a word from your local Fox station. Should be a fun second half coming up in St. Louis. Jamie Martin and the Rams offense getting set to go. They will have the ball as we begin the second half. Let's go down to Pam Oliver. Pam.
All right, Joe. Talked to both coaches at halftime. First, Mike Martz. He says he feels like the team responded well with Kurt Warner out and Jamie Martin in. He says he will not alter his play calling because of the quarterback situation. He just feels that Jamie needs to be more aggressive passing the ball. As for the Dallas Cowboys, Dave Campo says defensively, same game plan. Get after the quarterback. They want to run the ball better. Back to you.
All right, Pam. That last drive by the Rams, guys, not only tied the score, but it got some life back around here. And I think no matter who you talk to, they say that we're just lacking that spark. Maybe the spark's back in an ironic fashion because of the injury to Warner.
And remember 100 years ago when we started this game, when the storyline was the two offensive lines and what they could get done. Clearly the storylines have changed just a little bit as this game has gone on today.
You know, I think if you look at the guy who's really probably gone unnoticed in this game is Quincy Carter. The job that he's done, he's only had three incompletions, and he may not be playing like Donovan McNabb, but he's certainly playing a lot like Kurt Warner.
Well, Kurt Warner isn't going to be playing for a while, it would seem, and it's going to be a battle between Carter and Martin. There are the three incompletions on the part of Quincy Carter, 14 out of 17. Pass yardage actually favors the Rams. Total yardage to the Rams, and that last drive has a lot to do with it. 13 first downs to the Cowboys, 9. But then that big stat, turnovers. Time of possession, that has always been the blueprint to try and beat the Rams in years past, is hang on to the ball and keep it away from Warner and company.
And I wonder if Mike Martz will come back out with that 2-minute offense. That seemed to give him a little spark at the end of the half.
Knorr kicks it away, and Wilkins from the goal line. Cut it up and got a few extra yards. You're going to mark him out of bounds right at the 25. Wayne Goodrich made the stop.
Well, you look there at Jamie Martin's numbers, and he played well too. And you got to consider that this is a guy who doesn't get any reps in the week leading up to the game. Kurt Warner is a guy who wants to take all the snaps, so you know he's coming in cold. And for him to be able to come in and do what he's been able to do and get this offense ignited and get a little emotion behind him, that's an impressive job there in that first half.
Spreading it out here early on.
Falk in the backfield, and he gets it. It goes nowhere. So the Rams keep it on the ground with the first play from scrimmage as Aikman made the stop. He's back in there after being yanked out of the lineup by Dave Campo after the roughing the passer call late in the first half.
And Marshall Faulk's a guy that seems to get better as the season goes along. You look at his statistics month by month, and September has always been the least yards per carry as far as Marshall Faulk was concerned.
Second down and 10. Fake toss. Pressure. Martin hangs in and completes it. What a throw to Holtz. And Martin got crunched after he got rid of it.
What a great job by Jamie Martin of hanging in there. Brandon Noble, the nose tackle right here, number 75, is going to come after him. And he comes untouched, puts a big hit on Jamie Martin. And that looked like Kurt Warner as far as hanging in the pocket, taking the hit, delivering a perfect strike to Torrey Holtz.
And Derek Ross just missed making the same kind of interception that Darren Woodson did earlier, falling back underneath that corner route.
Marshall Faulk lowers his head and picks up 6.
Wow, I tell you what, if Marshall Faulk's neck is hurting him, you couldn't tell it by that play. I think that one dropped screen pass by Marshall Faulk got him a little fired up. You saw him go over to the sideline, sling his helmet. He wasn't happy with himself. And I know sometimes when you have an injury, you have a tendency to be a little hesitant. That hesitation is now gone for Marshall Faulk.
Yeah, you can hear the collision right there. Second down and four. Faulk met at the line of scrimmage and thrown backward. A loss on the play. Two. Well, and that's Kevin Hardy, the guy they brought in, linebacker, Jacksonville last year. And he's really been a great addition. We talked about Leroy Glover and his job in the locker room and being a leader for this football team. Kevin Hardy is that same guy. And he does a lot of different things. He can play the run, but he also has been brought in order to be able to rush the passer. And his knee, he had a bad knee injury a year ago, and it seems to be fine. And he's running very well with it.
Opening drive of the second half. Third and six. Blitz coming. Rams pick it up. And the pass is behind Faulk. It hit Copley in the back.
What another nice job there of protection. And the Cowboys trying to bring Roy Williams off the corner to put pressure. And Ernie Conwell, they kept in. They're tied in. And he does a nice job of seeing it and picking it up. And giving Jamie some time to throw the football. And looked like he might have had a shot had he have thrown a little better pass. Might have had a shot at a completion.
Boy, it sure is nice having a linebacker like Dexter Copley that can run like that, though. He was 25 yards down the field.
Third punt for Mitch Berger. Swinton will let it go over his head and into the end zone. One aspect of the Rams so far has been Berger able to drop it inside the 20. This time he can't, and the Cowboys have it. First crack at it on offense for Quincy Carter and the Dallas Cowboys in a 7-7 game. During the break, we thought, uh-oh, we've made a mistake. There's a flag on the field. We shouldn't have gone to commercial, but somebody lost their flag. Where'd that come from?
So I wonder what would have happened if there had been a pass interference on the next. Had to throw your shirt out there.
From their own 20. Emmett Smith. Gain of five on first down. And we talk baseball. Playoffs will start. The magical matchups Tuesday. Game one, division series. You know the matchups by now. Prime time, 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific. Sox are not going to make it this year. We're eliminated in May. Looked like a mistake on the handoff as Hambrick almost ran into Quincy Carter. No gain on the play. Third down coming up for Dallas.
Yeah, that's exactly right. It looked like just a miscommunication on exactly the ball handling that was taking place there. That play didn't have a chance from the start.
And the Cowboys need to get something going on offense. They had the one nice drive, and that looks like somebody needs to put a 10 over that circus. But this is an offense that really has four offensive touchdowns in four games, and they have been running in the mud here for the last quarter and a half.
They're back out of the blitz, running with Hambrick. The Cowboys do. Penalty flags on the play. And Hambrick is brought down right at the first down marker. Looked like he was brought down short. And the Rams are indicating it's a hold against Dallas. Hambrick was inches short of a first down anyway. And we'll see if the Rams accept the penalty.
Well, one of the things that the Cowboys like to do with their wide receivers is bring them down in motion. They like to bring them down in motion, and you see right there, 87, Kenyon Rambo, he will grab Leonard Little, bring him to the ground, and that's who they got for the holding.
Those wide receivers are strong guys, though, man. That was good. You're going to yank them down, yank them good.
I don't think Campo's going to be too impressed with the
holding. Offense, number 87. Penalty is declined, fourth down.
Because Hambrick was literally inches short of the first down, the Rams decline the penalty. It brings up fourth and inches, and the Cowboys bring their punt team on the field.
And they have tried everything possible to get Leonard Little blocked today, and none of it's worked. They've tried tight ends, they've tried backs, they've tried their tackles, now they're trying their wide receivers. Leonard Little so far the defensive MVP for the Rams.
Wilkins waiting deep. Little broke through but could not get to Norm. Fair catch called for by Terrence Wilkins, who has made his biggest contribution on special teams. The Rams get it back in a tie game. We welcome you back to St. Louis. Troy Aikman landed here the other day. You went to visit your very good friend and former coach, Ernie Zampezi.
Yeah, I sure did. And he was coordinated a lot of great offenses, one that I had a chance to be a part of, made a lot of great friends and a lot of special relationships. We're glad he's doing well. He's back home watching this game. Hello, Ernie.
Falk has the ball pop out as he hits the ground. Edwards, a good play, a gain of five. Ernie Zampezi suffering a stroke a week ago, and that's going to take him out of the mix as part of Mike Martz's not only coaching staff, but one of his confidants and somebody he can lean on with all that experience. Edwards is down and grabbing his left side, left arm, after making a very good tackle, flipping Marshall Falk.
And I tell you what, it's a tough spot here. They don't have many corners left that are active.
Second down for the Rams when we come back.
From their own 31.
Mario Edwards being looked at on the sideline, and Dwayne Goodrich comes in and takes over at right corner. Second down and five for the Rams. Blitz coming. Quick throw to Falk. 28, Woodson came on the blitz. The pass was complete to Falk, but only for 2 yards.
That's a good job by Darren Woodson getting in there and getting pressure. It's also a nice job by Jamie Martin getting rid of the football, but what the Cowboys wanted to accomplish, they were able to get him to make Martin get rid of the football early. He does, but then Kevin Hardy's there to make the play.
Well, the other thing the Cowboys are doing today is they feel like they need to run blitz, not necessarily in passing situations to blitz, but when they think the Rams are going to run the football, that's when they want to come bring the pressure.
Third and three. Out of the backfield, Falk, and a first down for the Rams. I mean, if you're Dallas, don't you have to have somebody just looking at Marshall Falk on every play now with Jamie Martin and a quarterback? If you didn't already coming into this game?
Well, you obviously do, because everybody that plays against the Rams knows, as we take a look there at Mike Zimmer, who puts together this defense, and everybody coming in knows Marshall Falk is going to be the guy you're trying to get the ball to. It's just that they can align him in so many different positions. You can't go man-to-man with him because he's too good for that. So you got to zone him, but you're never really sure where it is he's going to be.
Edwards back in the lineup. First down for St. Louis. A pocket for Martin, and the catch is made. Ball was down before it popped out. Torrey Holt with the reception. Coakley made the stop, and a minimal gain on the play.
A couple of points there on that one. One, Dexter Coakley can really run. When he locks in on a receiver and decides he's going to go get him, he can get there in a big hurry. But the other point being, this Rams offensive line is really doing a pretty nice job. I really didn't think they'd be able to get the Cowboys block coming into this one, but they've gotten it done.
Second down and nine after that completion to Holt for one. Four-man rush. Marshall Falk.
Marshall Falk.
He got to the 41. That's it. A gain of two. Conservative on this drive so far for the Rams.
Looked like that ball almost popped out again on Marshall Falk. Got hit right on it with a helmet. And I think that's the reason you didn't see his typical spin or fancy move inside the hole. He had to fight back and get the football.
Yeah, and early on in this ball game, we saw Marshall Falk getting the ball on the ground. He was making some big gains. You mentioned the line, the job that they're doing in pass protection. They are doing a good job there, but they've been unable to move out this defensive line for the Cowboys and create some running lanes for Marshall Falk.
Well, you saw Falk tell Larry Nemers the ball's wet. So before the play, and with the play clock down at 15 and counting, Nemers blew his whistle, went in and got a dry ball.
That shouldn't happen in a dome, should it?
You wouldn't think. Unless you're just sweating so profusely that it's just too hard to hang on to. Third and seven. Decent protection again. Ricky Prohl has a first down for St. Louis. First time we've said Prohl's name today, and what's new? Another first down catch for number 87.
And Ricky Prohl is one of the guys who I really think is one of the underappreciated guys for this team, and not within the organization, but I think for the fans and the press. And you see what he does here. He does a great job of coming out on the route, knowing where the soft spot is in that defense, and making the play. And I've talked about it before. It seems like whenever you need a key play, a key reception, Ricky Prohl is the guy usually bringing it in.
Play clock at 7. Quick throw, the ball's tipped and incomplete. Another blitz by the Dallas Cowboys. Keith Adams in the middle of that play.
Keith Adams getting his chance to play today, and you know, he was actually the third middle linebacker. Dat Wynn goes down and Jamal Brooks goes down, and so all of a sudden you're looking at Keith Adams, and he got a start last week, and you know, he runs real well. He's got some areas where he's got to improve in, but for a guy who hasn't had much playing time, he's really done a nice job for this team.
Second down and 10 now. Martin steps up, has his man wide open. That's Bruce, and that's a first down at the Dallas 31.
I don't care who you are. If you get protection like John St. Clair is giving out here on the outside against Greg Ellis. Greg Ellis is 4.5 sacks on the season. That's second in the National Football League. And John St. Clair is supposed to be a liability. Perfect protection. Give Jamie Martin a chance to step up. That's easy then.
So now inside Dallas territory.
I think the thing you're also starting to sense, you're really starting to sense the confidence grow for Jamie Martin with each completion that he gets.
Well, nothing new for these fans. The Rams have to burn a timeout trying to get a play in.
Fox NFL Sunday is brought to you by Southwest Airlines, proud sponsor of the NFL and official airline of Super Bowl 37. By Visa, it's everywhere NFL fans want to be. By WebMD, the place America comes for healthcare answers. And by Toyota, get the feeling.
Quincy Carter can just try to loosen up and watch as the Rams go down the field on the Dallas defense. First down, St. Louis at the 31. Holt. They're going to mark him down at the 25. Gain of 6. And now a penalty flag comes in late.
Tackle by Ross. Penalty flag down.
Going to move St. Louis back. It could be on one of those offensive linemen getting downfield and delivering a late blow.
Unsportsmanlike conduct. After the play was over on the offensive team, number 70, who was taunting. The down will count at second down, 15 yards from the end of the run.
Well, you called it, Joe. You see right there, number 70, John St. Clair, and here's the one they're going to get right here. That's the one the official always sees. They never see what happens leading up to it. They get the guy who makes the last blow.
He didn't look like the taunter. He looked like the tauntee in that one.
That's a major penalty called against St. Louis. It takes the ball all the way back to the 40 and brings up second and 19. Going to say, I can't believe St. Clair's gotten to the point where he's taunting. But he had had enough. And now Dallas jumps.
That's a great job by the quarterback there. Great job by Jamie Martin using snap count as a weapon to draw off the defense and help get some of those yards back. He'll pick up 5 yards here.
Leroy Glover looked like he was starting the 100 meters.
Yeah, I think they had passing downs in mind. They were coming after him.
On the defense, number 97. 5-yard penalty, still second down.
And we really can't emphasize enough the job the Rams are doing with their protection, because now what we're seeing out of Mike Martz is a willingness to open up this offense, to put the three wide receivers, to put the four wide receivers in, because now he has faith in what Grant Williams and John St. Clair are doing.
And that's where the Rams have an advantage on this Dallas secondary. Three wide receivers in here. Second down. Wide open throw. Did you see that little move to turn his body to end up going forward as he made that catch and pick up a couple extra yards?
Well, it really does a nice job, there's no question. And Cris, you talked about the confidence that they're getting with the tackles and the offensive line. Here's a look at the play here.
Look at this protection
again. And Jamie Martin again throwing a strike. And to go back on that, he's also showing, Mike Martz is also showing confidence in Jamie Martin. And yesterday he talked to us about having trust in his players. He's showing the confidence and showing Jamie Martin that he has trust in him by calling some of the plays that he's calling in this game.
No sacks all day for the Dallas defense. They come with a blitz. That's Conwell. And that's a first down and another pretty throw by Martin.
That's just a great job by an offensive football team overcoming an adverse situation. You get the penalty would set you back, and being able to go down the field and pick up this first down says a lot for this team right now.
And for Jamie Martin as well, with Kurt Warner on the sideline, a guy that is not getting the reps in practice. My guess is he probably ran four or five plays with the first string offense all week to understand that blitz protection, get the ball out hot, and pick up the first down.
Another blitz over the middle. Marshall Faulk with a move. Down to the six.
The Cowboys are reverting back to what they did last week. They want to bring pressure. They bring Darren Woodson off the edge. They don't get there. They're able to get the ball to Marshall Faulk. And from this point on, it's just purely number 28. What a great job of running, making guys miss and getting some yards.
How about Martin on this drive? 8 out of 9. Second and one. Faulk brought down in the backfield, and a good play by Darren Woodson.
You know, I tell you, we talk so much about Emmitt Smith and the record that he's going to have. But the one guy that who has been such a great football player for the Dallas Cowboys for so long, Darren Woodson, is already the second leading tackler by the end of this season. He's probably going to catch and pass Leroy Jordan, be the all-time leader in Cowboys history in tackles, whether it be in the secondary or coming up and blitzing or making plays against the run. Darren Woodson's a great football player.
Third and three. With time, incomplete. Back of the end zone, and nearly a circus catch by Torrey Holt.
And I was at the Rams practice on Friday, and Torrey made that circus catch that day. They worked on that play right there. They talked to Kurt Warner at the time. He was the one throwing the ball in practice about getting it up high, allowing Torrey to have an opportunity to bring it in. You see the athleticism and his ability to leap.
Wow.
And at the last minute, it's Mario Edwards knocking it out of his hands. Otherwise, that's a touchdown.
Because that would have been a force out. If he had just come down with the ball, they would have ruled force out and touchdown.
27-yard try. Put St. Louis on top for the first time today. And for the first time in a long time, the Rams have the lead with 2:05 left in the third quarter. This is the latest the Rams have had the lead in a game all season. 2:05 left in the third quarter. It's 10-7 St. Louis. And it's Jamie Martin leading the offense down the field on an 8.5-minute drive.
That was a real good drive by the Rams. And as we talked about, it was a great job of them overcoming the penalty and getting down there. Also, however, a good job by the Cowboy defense keeping them out of the end zone.
But I also think that Cowboys defense is starting to wear down. And if this Cowboys offense doesn't get it going here pretty soon, could end up being a blowout here at the fourth quarter.
Swint from the two. Swinton down near the 24-yard line.
You just can't expect your defense to hold up forever when your offense is just constantly going punt, 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 into half, punt. At some point, you have to step up and make some plays. They don't seem to have a lot of confidence in their running game, and they've been able to complete some passes underneath, but really no threats whatsoever down the field.
Six. Well, you look at Grant Wistrom. He works up inside. He goes inside of Flozell Adams. He's yelling at the official, thinking he got hold. No question. No question he got grabbed there. And Grant runs over to the official saying, hey, if that's not hold, there is no such thing as a hold in this league.
Second down and four. Quick throw. Caught. Tackled immediately as Bryant with a first down.
Remember, the Cowboys opened the game with a little hesitation and go route to Antonio Bryant. Got in behind Aeneas Williams. Maybe just about time for something like that again. I played in Bruce Coslett's offense in Cincinnati, and it's really shrunken here with the Dallas Cowboys. I know he likes to run the football, play action, get it down the field, but with the lack of running game, hasn't been able to do it.
Emmitt Smith cuts back, but just does not have the jets. A gain of only one. He had a lot of room out here to run, but just couldn't get it started.
Well, first it looked like there was a little miscommunication as far as the handoff, but once he got the ball in his hands, there's no question there was tremendous hesitation on him running. And you look at what he's done in this game, 11 rushes, 53 yards, but 30 of those came on one play. So you're talking about basically 10 runs for 23 yards, and that's just a little over 2 yards per carry.
Second down, and now Smith drops it.
And Troy, I want to get back to what we were talking about just a moment ago, and that is the Cowboys' new run blocking scheme. It's a zone blocking scheme. It's not you're just taking a guy and trying to drive him off the ball. You're trying to get position, moving out in front of the guy, sometimes passing him off to the guy that comes in behind him. And right now, Emmitt Smith is taking it all the way behind the blocking scheme where there is no protection. He has to get out in front and then make his cut.
Third and nine. Catch is made and out of bounds. It appears with a first down as Whalen, who's been a favorite target of Quincy Carter here today.
Yeah, and James Whalen is a guy who has put on some weight. When he first joined the Cowboys, he was undersized. They didn't know for sure whether or not he'd be a very effective tight end because he's not a very good blocker, but they've been able to put a little weight on him. And then also utilize some of the things that he does best. He's not asked to do a lot of blocking. He gets out there in the H-back and makes plays like that.
Last play of the third quarter. Airing it out. Bly with the interception. That should be a penalty on Bly for taking his helmet off. But the meat of the play is right here with Bly catching it over his shoulder like he was the intended receiver. And what a way for the third quarter to come to a close. The Rams will have it when we come back. The NFL on Fox will continue after a word from your local Fox station.
Well, we were expecting Bruce Coslett to take a shot at some point. This time, Dre Bly really just playing it perfectly. And the run out actually helped him to some extent because he got a running start on Joey Galloway. It looked like Galloway hesitated for just a moment, maybe trying to figure out or not expecting the ball to come in. And then Dre Bly doing what we've seen all season long. I don't know why it's not a 15-yard penalty. And it should have been.
Yeah, you know what? I think that if at any point, if a player takes their helmet off, whether they take it off, walk into the sidelines, at any point, if they take a helmet off on the field of play, they should be penalized.
Unless you're a Browns fan. From their own three, Marshall Faulk gets it to the five.
Gain of two.
But despite the interception, it's not a horrible play for the Dallas Cowboys if their defense can come out here and shut them down in three plays and force the punt. Then you get the ball back somewhere around midfield. So a really important sequence right now for the Rams and for the Cowboys.
Jump too soon.
Well, if you want to know what it sounds like.
False start, 86 offense, half the distance to the goal, still second down.
To be down on the football field, you got a pretty good feel for it right there. All the calls being made by both the offensive lines and the defensive lines and linebackers trying to get people situated. And sometimes somebody on the offensive line or a tight end will hear one of those defensive calls and mistake it for the snap count.
Yeah, if you're going to go offside, down there is where to do it. It was only 2.5 yard penalty. Second and 10. Nearly picked off. Williams had a shot at it. Edwards did as well, and when Williams and Edwards came together, the ball came out.
Yeah, Williams was coming across. He had the chance to get it, and he's the safety coming over the top. You see him right there, and then him and Edwards, he had it in his hands. Edwards knocks it out, and Isaac Bruce, he's got to go back and try to get a make a play on that ball. He just stood and watched it all happen, and I don't know if the ball got tipped or not. It might have, but
tell you what, a huge sigh of relief over there on that Rams sideline after that throw, though. That was a duck.
Play clock down to one. Up the middle, no one there. Bruce was the closest to it. Now exactly what you talked about, Cris, like a good punt. The Cowboys figure to get it back, even with that interception, with pretty good field position.
They get it back with good field position. The other thing to make note of here is that Mitch Berger is not going to be getting the full 15 yards that he's used to on the punts. And that's, as an offense, the first thing you want to do when you're backed up is you want to get that first down at least one so you can give your punter some room. You can see right here, he's going to be limited to about a 12-yard drop to punt this ball.
But they're not trying to block it.
Poor punt. Line drive and a chance for Swinton. Trying to find room to run, and he's got it. Good field position inside the 35. With that little room to work, Berger gets off a line drive, and Swinton a good return. First down for Dallas from the Ram 34. Hand off to Emmitt Smith. Down to the 29.
Emmitt Smith, the ball carrier.
Gain of five. Ryan Pickett made the stop.
That's a great first down play for the Dallas Cowboys just to get them started. There really hasn't been many running lanes so far in this ball game, and Ryan Pickett coming back from that cracked kneecap, boy, did he explode off the ball there and almost hit him in the backfield.
On second down, Smith trying to get outside, can't. Penalty flag on the play. Pickett claiming he was held, and he may be right. This is a hold against Dallas and a huge Cowboy penalty. Pickett's been a handful here in this second half.
Holding offense number 65. 10-yard penalty. Repeat. Second down.
It's probably something Gerard wouldn't have to do, but for the knee injury he sustained late in the week of practice, you just unable to get out in front to make the block there, so just grab a big chunk of the jersey, and then it still paid the price. That's a huge penalty, knocking them back out of field goal range.
Second and 17 from the 41.
They really wanted to work Darnay Scott back into this offense. He played with Bruce Coslett in Cincinnati, felt like he had a better understanding of what they're trying to do out there, but you have to catch this football. This puts you right back in field goal range. It's an easy catch, no excuse whatsoever.
And Grant Winstrom, I'll tell you what, he's been close a lot today. He's been putting a lot of pressure on Quincy Carter.
Third down. Catch made, but way shy of a first down. And you wonder what the play call is there.
Well, I think what they're trying to do there is get something that will allow them to get into field goal position and try to make a field goal attempt.
They didn't succeed.
They didn't get nearly enough yards. The route wasn't nearly deep enough to do that. Now they're going to have to be punting the football.
So you could question that play call only because, forget the first down, they didn't have near enough yardage to bring Billy Cundiff, their field goal kicker, onto the field. That'll be a delay game, and the Cowboys couldn't care less.
Now, I don't know what kind of range Cundiff has, but when you're in a dome and you're at the 35-yard line, that makes it, what, 53-yard field goal. Most kickers in the National Football League want to take a shot from there.
But well, you can't take that risk with a rookie kicker.
Offense, penalty is declined, fourth down.
That's a big risk because they would be getting the ball where it is that they're trying to attempt a field goal, but one of the reasons Billy Cundiff made this football team was because of the fact that he has the strong leg.
Mark! Mike Adore.
Catch it.
The Cowboys let it drop, and it goes into the end zone. Randall Williams had a chance to catch it, and he let it bounce, and Joe Avizzano's hot.
Because the receiver wasn't in position, they could have literally caught the ball themselves there and downed it.
Fox NFL Sunday is brought to you by Ford. No boundaries. By Sprint, introducing PCS Vision. Clearly a whole new way to look at wireless. By Dr. Pepper and your local Dr. Pepper bottler. Be you, nothing's better, Dr. Pepper. And by Subway, fresh made sandwiches on fresh baked bread. Subway, eat fresh.
Who would have thought with 11 and a half minutes remaining in this game that we'd be able to say the Rams offensive line has outplayed the Dallas offensive line. Starting with it from their own 20. And St. Clair was off and moving before the snap.
Before the ball was snapped, false start on the offense, number 77. 5-yard penalty, still first down.
Take a look at the recap. And obviously the biggest story of the day still is the injury to Warner, the broken pinky. The throw to Darnay Scott for the first 7 points of this game, but Jamie Martin had an answer to Isaac Bruce. Put a big smile on the face of Kurt Warner. First time he smiled in a while. It's first and 15. Toss to fall. Trying to get that 5 yards back. Instead, he got three. Look at it statistically. Jamie Martin's thrown for 225 yards with a touchdown and a pick. Quincy Carter's thrown only 6 incompletions with a touchdown and a pick. Marshall Faulk over 120 total yards. And Emmett Smith, 12 carries for 51 yards, but there's a 30-yarder mixed in there. Second down and 12. Finally, Martin gets pressure, and the incompletion will bring up third and long.
Yeah. Kevin Hardy that time went down as a fifth defensive lineman on the outside working against St. Clair, and you can see the quickness out of Kevin Hardy and the hold by John St. Clair. It's one of the things that they really liked about Hardy. They didn't feel like Jacksonville used him as much as a pass rusher as they would have had they brought him here. They dropped him back into coverage. The plan in Dallas was to bring him and bring him after the quarterback.
Delayed handoff. That's Faulk. short of a first down by a yard. Dixon came up and made a big stop.
And Dexter Coakley right here, he gets leveled. Andy McCollum, the center, just lays him out. Marshall Faulk got real close to picking up that first down.
As Howie Long likes to say, the big truck beats the little truck every time.
Dixon really made a first down saving hit on Marshall Faulk. And on fourth and a yard, the fifth punt from Berger. Much better punt. And it's tapped down by the Rams. Back inside the 25. 40-yard punt. And the Cowboys will have it at their own 24-yard line. Quincy Carter back to work with the Cowboys down 3. The Dallas offense has been shut down by this Rams defense, which started the day ranked 16th in the league. Under 10 to play. Fake reverse. Carter keeps it, nowhere to throw it. So now he's flushed and running and sliding forward. Marked down right at the first down marker.
That was really pretty well designed by the Cowboys. They had run the reverse earlier, and now they come off of it with the fake. Quincy Carter fakes it there. They're looking for Joey Galloway down the field, but the Rams do a great job with Kim Herring and Adam Archuleta right there. They see it the whole way. They don't give the Cowboys an opportunity to throw the football. Quincy does the smart thing, the thing that so many people have been wanting to see him do, and takes off scrambling and gets a big game.
Got the first down. Penalty flags before the snap.
Prior to the ball being snapped, false start in the offense, number 70. 5-yard penalty, still first down.
Boy, I'm telling you, when you're struggling on offense anyway, to start out first and 15 instead of first and 10 really makes a difference. Javier Collins that time with the false start.
Dallas, first and 15.
Last season, 45 carries, 150 yards for Carter. So far this year, 9 for 20. Over the middle, caught by Galloway. Brought down short of a first down by 2 yards, and we go to Los Angeles for a game break in James Brown.
Hey, Joe, Saints were trailing by 16. Cut it to 8 here. Look at Deuce McAllister. Nifty moves up the gut 12 yards for the score. Aaron Brooks with a 2-point conversion. It's now 23-15 Detroit. Game now in the fourth. Back to Joe, Troy, and Chris.
Pam Oliver as well, and thanks for handing it back. We mentioned that last week New Orleans came back from a 20-0 deficit against Chicago and tried to spoil the day for Marty Mornhinweg and the Detroit Lions today.
Yeah, and I think that's what makes the NFL so great, is that on any given week anybody can play, and really exciting for the fans to support this game.
Second down and 2. Play action. Over the middle, the fullback Thomas has a first down. Just shy of the 49-yard line.
Leonard Little really taking an inside move here, coming right on the inside, which opens up the outside that time for Robert Thomas to get an easy completion and created a short corner.
First down and incomplete. Again, it was Whalen, the intended receiver. It's a Fox NFL Sunday doubleheader next week, beginning with America's number one pregame show. JB, Terry, Howie, and Jimmy get you ready for kickoff. Then it's Michael Strahan and the New York Giants taking on these Cowboys. Or the late game is St. Louis out on the coast to take on San Francisco in an NFC West battle. Noon Eastern, 9 a.m. Pacific next week. Hambrick. Troy Hambrick with a first down. Wistrom yelling at the rookie Robert Thomas after that play.
Well, and that's the thing that the Cowboys are able to do when they have Hambrick in the ball game. They spread him out with a three wide set. They limit the number of defenders in the box. They come back and they hand it to Hambrick, and he's able to get outside, and he does a nice job of showing a burst once he gets to that sideline and picking up some yards.
And he stays in the game. That's the important thing when you have a run like that.
And they pitch it to him. Wistrom chasing him. And the tackle made that time. Bly stood his ground. A gain of three.
Joey Galloway could have made this play go. Misses a block on the outside. And Dre Bly able to avoid that one and come up and make the stick. But I tell you what, that's the hardest run I've seen out of Troy Hambrick. Really lowered his shoulder and got the extra yard.
And you talk about Joey Galloway and his block there. And when the play is going to be that slow to develop, you don't want to try to cut the corner. You got to stay up high on him.
Good point.
Dallas with some life now. Quincy Carter throws on the run, and it's caught by Whalen. Another Dallas first down.
And guys, I don't think we can emphasize enough just how important this final 7 minutes are to these two football teams. I remember you're 1-2 for the Dallas Cowboys, you lose, you go to 1-3. You're 0-3 for the Rams, you lose, you go to 0-4. In all likelihood, one of these two teams kind of disappear after today and begin a slow fade.
Well, the Rams are looking like they're a real desperate team at this point. They should be.
That's Emmitt Smith. Gets smacked. He got a couple. Trying the left side on a cutback.
I think one of the things that has hurt this Rams team at this earliest stage in the season is that their defense has not been able to stop the opponents when they've had to on defense. And so last week they did a nice job in the second half against Tampa, but you go back to the Denver game, you go back to the Giant game, when they needed to make a stop, they were unable to do it, and they need to make a stop here.
Ninth play of the drive, second and seven. Bryant, penalty flag on the play. And Antonio Bryant is a yard shy of the first down.
That was a hell of a catch by Antonio Bryant, but it's going to come back. It looked like there was some kind of hole.
Penalty flag down. Larry Nemers is our referee. He'll give us a call.
Looked like Adam Archuleta coming on the blitz got held.
No foul on the right tackle, number 77. That was not a hold, it was a rip. But there is a hold on the back out of the backfield, number 22. That's a 10-yard penalty. Repeat second down.
Archuleta coming on the outside right there. I think they're saying there is no hold there, but Emmett's right up on the top. Maybe that's the hold.
Yeah, it looked like there were both holds. Really, they could have picked either one.
O.J. Brigance is in the lineup for St. Louis, at least was on that play, as the Rams took the rookie Robert Thomas out.
And for the second straight drive now, the Cowboys move down in field goal range and a holding penalty pushing them out to the brink of field goal range.
Last time it was Gerard. This time they at least call the number of Emmitt Smith. Play for Hambrick. Nice play by Tyoka Jackson. Big play for the Rams defense. A gain of only five.
It sure looked like it was going to be a lot bigger gain than that. It was a good call. Leonard Little coming off the edge, and good thing they had the screen play on. Right there, it looked like they had a chance to get a pretty big gain, but Tyoka Jackson pursuing it from the backside is able to make the tackle.
Third and 12. Quincy Carter looking to run. Quincy Carter slides short of a first down.
Oh, my goodness, Quincy Carter. Out of all the times to slide, he had the first down, I believe, picked up. If he just dives forward on this one. Now, I know there's no bright yellow line out there for the players, but this is the ball game. This is your season in many ways, and the decision to hook slide there really may have cost him a chance to keep this drive going.
Yeah, no question there. And the guy who was there that he had to run over was Dre Bly, 32, a defensive back. And I agree with you, Cris. In that situation, you've got to do what you can to pick up the first down. The kick is good, and we're tied 35 yards from Billy Kunda. It's 10-10 with under 4.5 to play in St. Louis. Quincy Carter slid down 2 yards shy of a first down, so Kunda hit the field goal. 35-yarder to tie the game at 10. Good drive, though, 11 plays covering 59 yards. Led by Carter. And now Micah Knorr will kick it away. Wilkins waiting deep. We'll try the near side. Nice cutback. Gets out to the 29. That's where the Rams will take over behind Jamie Martin. Think of the pressure on Mike Martz's quarterback, Jamie Martin, taking over in this game for the injured Kurt Warner. The Rams at 0-3. 10-10 with 4:15 remaining. Trying to set up a screen. Penalty flag on the play, and what a tackle by Roy Williams. Williams got Falk around the shoulder pads and ripped him to the ground.
And Jamie Martin, lucky that that ball wasn't intercepted. It went through about three hands of the Dallas Cowboys that had a chance at it.
Kevin Hardy again coming on the blitz and almost got there, kind of got knocked down at the last minute.
Tripping on the offense, number 61. That's a 10-yard penalty, still first down.
Tom Newton.
That's exactly what it was on Kevin Hardy right there as he went by. Really had no choice, but the silly thing, Troy, is it was a screen. So you don't care. The guy, as long as he's going to make a spin move,
I'm not sure
let him
he was
go.
Actually trying to. I don't know if that was a purposeful trip, but if it were, then you're right. You're running a screen, you want to allow the rush to come in and throw the ball in behind it.
Boy, since they started bringing Kevin Hardy, though, it's really helped the pressure.
So first and 20 for Jamie Martin in this Rams offense. Torrey Holtz falls forward short of the original line of scrimmage. A gain of 8. Let's go back to Los Angeles and a game break with James Brown.
Hey, Joe, as we know, Carolina trying to improve to 4-0 for the first time ever. Rodney P. play action. Hooking up with the fullback, Brad Hoover. That was the key play to set up that 2-yard run by Lamar Smith. His second touchdown run of the day. 14-10 Carolina. Back to Joe, Troy, Cris, and Pam.
Thanks, JB.
There you go.
They make you shake your head every week, Carolina.
Wow.
They sure do, and they're doing it there at Lambeau. Second down and 12. Wide open is Holtz. First down, St. Louis. At their own 47.
If the Cowboys don't win this game, this group right here just simply never got it done all day long. When they're not blitzing, they are not even getting close to Jamie Martin.
And you got Derek Ross, the rookie, out there trying to cover Holt. I mean, that's a mismatch, and no way Derek Ross is going to be able to slow him down.
Just shy of a 100-yard day for Holt. First down. Martin comes to this side and throws it incomplete. And Holt was surprised the ball ended up on his side of the field. Brandon Noble had pressure on that last play. The day for Jamie Martin didn't start out well at all. frustration, but he hung in and found Isaac Bruce for a touchdown. He's had a good day statistics-wise, and now he has an opportunity to lead the Rams down the field, possibly to their first victory of the year.
Yeah, I don't know if you can say enough for the job that he has done here in this game coming off the bench.
Holmes, perfect throw, short of a first down by about a yard and a half. Mario Edwards made the quick tackle.
And Torrey Holt, coming off a career-high 12 catches against the Bucks, to me has really become one of the great receivers in this league. I know that sometimes we have a tendency to group all these receivers together, but boy, what a player he's turned into.
The Rams can let the clock wind down to the 2-minute warning if they wish. Cowboys showing blitz, and they come. End around, first down easy for Bruce. Stays in bounds. We've hit the 2-minute warning. And the Cowboys may have to hit the panic button. 13-yard gain on third and a yard and a half. That's the Mike March we're used to seeing, and the Rams we're used to seeing on the move. A minute 56 remaining. The Rams have two timeouts. Dallas all three of their timeouts. And if the Rams start moving it deeper into Dallas territory, they're going to have to start thinking about using their timeouts on defense. A 10-10 game with a minute 56 remaining. And a first down for St. Louis at the Dallas 32. Marshall Faulk. Inside the 30 of the 27. Gain of six. Pepe Zellner made the tackle. Timeout, Dallas. Take a break. Come right back. Jeff Wilkins wondering if he'll get an opportunity today to put the Rams back on top. Made 38 of his last 40 inside 40 yards. The Rams are at the Dallas 27 and do an end around to Ernie Conway. He gets to the 25 and Roy Williams made the hit there, and the Cowboys will spend their second timeout.
Yeah, what a good play by Roy Williams. Showing his speed. Ernie Conwell, obviously not the fastest guy, but they tried to set it up, and then Roy Williams coming over and cutting him off with his angle, and they weren't able to get as much out of the play as what it originally appeared they might get.
He was highly celebrated rookie, their first pick coming out of Oklahoma, and he's not really been able to do what he does best so far, which is hang around near the line of scrimmage and make those big plays. Had to be used more in pass coverage help, which doesn't really suit his style.
Because they're so weak at the cornerback position. But this is the play of the ball game right here now. If they can hold them on this down, call the timeout, even if they make the field goal, you have time to put something together for the Cowboys on offense.
Third and three. How will this Rams offense try to get the first down? They're going to throw, and Martin is sacked for the first time today. And who is it? Roy Williams ends up on top of him.
Well, it's unfortunate Jamie Martin didn't get more time. You watch Ernie Conwell, there's nobody there. He runs right by, it looks like, Darren Woodson. And here's the pressure that he gets.
Ellis first to get there, and Williams was there. If Ellis couldn't bring down Martin, and what a time for the Cowboys' first sack of the day.
Yeah, and I like the aggressiveness there of Mike March, putting the game in Jamie Martin's hands, letting him try to pick up the first down through the air. Good call. They had the guy open again. It was just protection that broke down that kept them from getting a big play.
Well, but what you've done by throwing the ball there is also put your field goal kicker now back to about 49 yards. Had they just handed the football off, you've got about a 41, 42 yarder up there. And for Jeff Wilkins, you've got to think pretty good shot from there. This is more of a 50-50 proposition.
49-yard try. Dallas just had to spend their final timeout. Rookie snapper, throw holding. The kick hits the upright. Jeff Wilkins has gone to kicking without a shoe on his right foot. This one barely got there and then hit the right upright about the spot where it meets the crossbar. And with that miss, Dallas ends up with terrific field position.
And the one thing about Jamie Martin and his decision back there, and I know there's a zillion things going on and you don't always see the rusher, but if your coach lets you throw the football there, probably the last thing Mike Martz said in his headset was, don't take a sack, don't take a sack. He did, and probably cost him three.
Now Dallas an opportunity with Quincy Carter over the middle. Wiley with a catch. Remember, Dallas, no timeouts remaining. 6-yard completion on first down.
But lots of time here.
Penalty flags before the play. There was movement along the line of scrimmage.
Prior to the snap, false start on the offense, number 87. That's a 5-yard penalty. Still second down.
Go back to that key sack once again, and Jamie Martin here with time now to get rid of it. He doesn't see it coming from the backside, but at some point when you know the blitz is coming, just get the ball out of there. Don't take the sack. Don't allow your team to be forced into a 50-yard field goal.
Solomon Page now out of the game. Setting up a screen for Hambrick. And a tackle off the corner by Dre Bly.
Well, and again, that's Dre Bly going low, trying to hit him with a shoulder around the ankles. And you've got to come up and hit a guy and put your arms around him if you're going to make tackles in this league. I've seen that too many times from Dre Bly.
It's third down. Pressure on Carter. This time, forward for a first down.
There you go, Quincy Carter. That's better. Now with the game on the line, he dives forward. Now it's time for him to stop the clock. And he got hurt a little bit. He's limping around.
29 seconds remaining.
I didn't see who it was that time, but somebody made a huge blitz pickup on that last player. Quincy Carter would have been sacked. There you go. Quincy Carter now, this time with the ball game on the line. No hook slide here. Diving forward, and he needed every inch of that.
Just did get enough yardage for the first down. Otherwise, it would have been fourth down. Dallas, no timeouts remaining. Second and 10. Over the middle, Wiley. Down to the 35. And now up to the line to spike it again. And do you want to risk it and run another play or take Cundiff, put him on the field with a chance to win it?
Boy, Dre Bly almost took Quincy Carter's head off on that last one. A delayed blitz coming off the corner. Got there just about a half a second too late. You're going to see him coming right here, and nobody picks him up. Hambrick doesn't see him, and just 1 second too late.
Yeah, and it's because of that blitz, if Jamie Duncan went from the middle linebacker position out to cover the outside that left that big hole for that pass completion.
13 seconds remaining, no timeouts left. Over the middle! What a mistake. Now we'll see if the Cowboys can get up, line up, spike it in time. They do with 1 second remaining.
That was insane.
That was an awful big risk for 5 yards.
That was, I hope that the coaches didn't tell Quincy Carter to do that. I mean, that's taking a big risk. They lose the ball game if one more second comes off the clock. I thought they would have tried to throw something along the outside, pick up 5 yards, get out of bounds, and if you don't, you're still in position to go for the field goal attempt.
It's a tie game, 1 second remaining. 48-yard try. Rookie snapper and kicker. The kick is good, and the Cowboys are 2-2.
Boy, this looks like a college atmosphere. The Dallas Cowboys piling on top of each other in the middle of the field. It's like they won a bowl game. But you talk about the difference in two football teams, and this season for the St. Louis Rams, their field goal banks off the upright. For the Dallas Cowboys, theirs grazes off the upright and goes through.
Officially a 48-yarder, which is the long of the year and the career for the rookie Cundiff.
Credit the Cowboys for keeping Billy Cundiff. This training camp, they had Tim Cedar. They decided to go with the rookie because of the stronger leg. It paid off.
And now with the Dallas Cowboys moving to 2-2, the St. Louis Rams are left at 0-4 and without Kurt Warner. From one extreme to the other for Jamie Martin, and sheer ecstasy for the Dallas Cowboys. Norn knew it right away, and Cundiff wanted to keep watching. What was the reaction by Mike Martz? Nothing. Oh, and four are the NFC champion St. Louis Rams. I'm Joe Buck for Troy, Chris, and Pam. Let's go to bonus coverage of Chicago and Buffalo. Let's join Kenny Albert.